going on, guys? This is Wav here. Welcome back to some more Jurassic World. Last time we left off, we actually made this really, really nifty ME terminal, or wireless terminal, to access the ME terminal over there, and it is absolutely fantastic. I'm definitely looking forward to trying this out here in this episode, you know, to work on our penthouse up here, you know, customizing it, decorating it, make it look absolutely fantastic, and yeah, we can customize it from over here, or we can access it from over here, no problem whatsoever, and I kind of want to, before we jump on into whatever else we're going to do today, I kind of want to see exactly how far we can go. Oh, okay, we're out of range, like, right now. Okay. And I assume it doesn't really matter how far vertically you go. Okay, there we go. Oof. Seems like about right here is the limit. So this is really, really far away. This is farther than we usually go, even to go shear sheep, even though we don't need to do that anymore because we have a little sheep farm that we have going on now. Anyways, last episode, I did mention that, I'm getting some weird frame droppage. Anyways, last episode, I did mention that I did want to, make a little coelacanth or, like, a little aquarium or something over here. I was like, hey, we could probably put it, like, right here. I got a lot of comments suggesting it. And, it seems like this would be a really good place to put it. I also had a really nifty idea to put it, like, you know, on the ceiling. That way, if he looked up, he'd have coelacanth and stuff just swimming around on the ceiling. But I think we dug this a little bit too. I don't think it's going to happen. Yeah, it's a little bit, if we had like maybe 3, 4, 5 blocks right there, we would have easily been able to make a little ceiling aquarium right there. But alas, doesn't seem like that's the case. Let's get that super smooth sandstone to put it there. Hashtag super. Oh, whoa, Dr. Oh, man, Dr. Indominus, you're just speeding down the hallway over there while I was trying to hashtag it up. Anyways, I guess, yeah, we could put a little aquarium right here. Use some of the leftover blue glass, if we even have any blue. Yeah, we do. But it is stained glass panes, so I wonder if we can turn these back into glass. Like, I don't know, like smelt them again, or, okay, you can make blue cultivates out of them. But I don't think you can make glass out of them. What is this stuff? Kind of looks like the glow panel. Ooh, that'd be... What's that, HDPE sheet? How do you get that HDPE pellet? Is that some sort of plastic pellet? Substrate, oxygen, liquid ethylene. Okay, that's really interesting stuff. Maybe we dive into that stuff here later. Oof, that seems really interesting. Anyways, I don't think you can turn this into regular glass as far as I know. You can just chisel it into different panes. But as far, okay, we can't do that. Okay, well, we do have a lot of lapis, and I do believe we have some extra glass that's smelting. So, yeah, I had to accidentally kill a few sheep, and I got some muttons. Don't tell Whipper I did that. Anyways, let's see if we have any lapis, or at least how much, that's, oh man, 55 blocks, I just completely ignored that. We have way more than enough lapis, so let's actually see how much glass we have as well. Glass. We should have some because I smelted it because we need it for something. Where'd it go? Is it in my inventory? Oh, yeah, it is. It's literally in my inventory. There we go. 8 things of glass. Yeah, I definitely need to empty my inventory of all this extra garbage I have going on inside of here. Let's put all that garbage up there. All this applied energenistics stuff that we can just throw inside there. The extra couch. I don't know what we should do with the extra couch. Light gray wool, blah, blah, blah. Quartz fiber. Yeah, we could put that there. We could probably start throwing these ender pearls into the... Wait, what happened here? I thought... I broke the mailbox. I'm really sure I broke it last episode. Why does it keep appearing here? I need to unlock the mailbox to destroy it. Crouch and right-click the... Okay, maybe that's the reason why it keeps appearing, because I'm not destroying it properly. Okay, isn't that right, Dr. Down? You're coming over here just shaming me, just looking at me like, huh, wow, how do you not know that? Huh, trying to break my mailbox. Anyways, let's go over here. How deep should this be? Because I know the coelacanths get pretty big. Let's actually go check on our coelacanths. Let's see how big they are. Let's go to the very first dinosaur aquarium. Because those are, you know, the very first ones we put down. So obviously they're going to be the biggest. Let's go over here. Let's go check out their sizes, actually. Let's go over here. Oh, who's that? Is that... Oh, it's Nugget. Hey, how's it going, Nugget? How you doing? Let's go over here. Let's see how these coelacanths are doing. They're pretty big. Yeah, they are. I think 3 wide, 4 wide. Oh wow, I can actually like look right now. Yeah, he's about 4 blocks wide, so. And we had like a 3 block wide area we could put him there, so. I don't know, I'm thinking 6 blocks wide, you know, because he'll have a little area to swim around whenever he's a complete full-sized adult. Maybe three wide, but like really deep. Like it goes back really deep, like this. Like it's three wide here, but it'd be like 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we can dig it back. Like I don't know how many more blocks, but it'll be pretty deep. And yeah, I'm thinking that's probably the best course of action. Either that, or yeah, we can of course go up one more block here. I don't want to get rid of the little acacia here. You know, it kind of looks pretty good, if you ask me. It looks pretty good. Anyways, let's see. How far does this go back? So the glass would go here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So he'd be a full-size body if he's lengthwise looking out like that. So maybe one... Yeah, two more blocks? That shouldn't hurt, right? Two more blocks. Oh, there's a cave down there. Oh, spooky spookies down there. Let's just put the... Yeah, we're going to replace all these blocks here later, so... Let's put some cobblestone about right there. There we go. And... I don't know what... Quartz, maybe? Quartz inside, or maybe even more of the sandstone stuff. I need to go get the chisel and start converting the sandstone into the super duper smooth sandstone if I want to do that, though. It'd fit. Yeah, and of course we have to change the roof as well. And of course fill this whole entire thing up with water, which shouldn't be too hard. And yeah, I think it's possible. I think it's definitely possible. So, let's get our ME terminal. Let's see, let's get some sandstone, smooth sandstone, extra smooth sandstone I have left over. And let's see if we have the chisel inside here. Yeah, we still have the chisel. Or that's the carpenter's chisel. What happened to my other chisel? Should have broke by now, right? Chisel. I'm really sure that we... Yeah, there it is right there. Whatever that. I don't know, maybe it broke? Who knows? Anyways, or maybe I didn't put it in the right chest. I have no idea. Maybe I didn't put it in the ME network. Anyways, we should be able to craft it no problem real quick. Maybe with the materials we have in our inventory. Yeah, we can make it no problem. Let's get ourselves some acacia, sticks, and one thing of iron. And there's a chisel. Nice. So we just need to grab the chisel. God, stop opening up the camp studio thing. We just need to right click with a chisel, put the smooth sandstone there. And which one was it? I think it was that one. Yeah. Smooth and flat sandstone. There you go. So, let's go over here. Let's go place down all these over here. How's it going, Dr. Indominus? I'm just spiffing up your little apartment over here. Made it look fantastic. Let's change the ground first. Just so we can come back later and fill it up with water. And we can always change the walls later, you know? The ground's going to be the hardest thing to change in the future. And, you know, I don't know. Maybe change this one to a sideways acacia. Ooh, I was afraid that was acacia would have broke the whole entire thing right there. Oof. Let's grab the acacia. There we go. And let's put it like that. I only changed it because this one's kind of like in an up and sideways pattern. So that's why that's like that. But we can change it on this side. And is that sandstone or is that smooth? Okay, there's the smooth sandstone. I need to convert that. What are you doing inside there, Doctor? Now, get out of there. Get out of there. Yeah, get out of here. Oof. This is off limits for now. All right, let's keep on going back here. Okay, I need to measure this again. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so this is going to be the back wall. And there we go. And we just place it like so. And this is the roof. Yeah, this is the roof. So we could place sandstone up here as well. And this will be the back wall. Nice. And of course, we could put some glowstone back here, you know, light it up, make it look pretty good. And yeah, I'm thinking this thing is going to look fantastic here in a bit. Yeah, especially when we fill it up with water and go cultivate a coelacanth real quick. Maybe we have extra coelacanths. I don't know. Let's check the wireless terminal. Coelacanth. Yeah, we have some 100 DNA. We have 100 DNA, so we can definitely get ourselves one singular coelacanth. Hashtag singular coelacanth. And just hatch it down here, you know? All we have to do now is go cultivate a... Oh, not the chisel. All we have to do now is go cultivate ourselves a coelacanth, and we will be good to go. Wow, that's like exactly enough. Alright, let's put that there, just to make sure. If he goes back there, we can always just push him out. It'll be a lot easier. Anyways, there we go. Let's go get ourselves a coelacanth. Hey, how's it going, Dr. Indominus himself? Let's go over here. Let's go grab ourselves a bucket. There we go. Yep, we already have some bucket of waters. There we go. And I need to get one more bucket, so... that's not an infinite water pool. I know there is a machine that has, like, an infinite water pool, like, capabilities. I forgot what it was called. Aqueous Accumulator? Aqueous Accumulator, I think. Yeah, there it is right there. You need a pneumatic servo, a square glass, copper gear, and a bucket. Yeah, it should be pretty easy to, you know, get. I don't know where we'd put it, though. Maybe we could put it over here, move the analyzers over, or the extractors, whatever they're called. Jeez. Yeah, we could put them over there. Yeah. If our inventory wasn't completely full, actually, yeah, I could put this stuff up from here. Man, that's super convenient. Look at that. But the court stuff, whoa, man, you can see through the world right there. And put all this extra garbage I'm not going to be using. There you go. And let's just grab all the analyzers or extractors or whatever they're called. And, man, this world keeps on flashing on and off. That's terrible. Where should we put these? Maybe on this wall. Yeah. They'd be close to all the cultivators. So we could just put them on this wall. Maybe put them, like, facing this way, right? Yeah, there you go. Looks pretty good. 2, 3, 4. And we could put another one there, but I don't know. We could probably rotate it like this, right? Like that. Yeah. So they're kind of facing inward and outward. Or maybe have it go like this. Oh, whoa. Nasty lag. Okay, I don't know if the nasty lag is completely fixed or not, but hopefully it is. Yeah, I think it might be, because the T-Rex are just screaming outside, and we hear some hurrying going on, and Dr. Anonymous is moving around. Okay, oof. Anyways, this was what I was thinking about for the extractors, you know? Maybe we put another one up here, get rid of that torch, and of course we're going to have to, how do we put it like that? Yeah. I guess we'll have to make another one, just to kind of even it out, because it is off-center right now. How do you even make one of these extractors? Anyways, should be pretty easy, because we made them really, yeah. Tin block, redstone block, and glass. And iron blocks, yeah. Let's get some tin blocks. Oof, we don't have enough tin. You kidding me? Wow. How do we not have, like, any tin? I guess we can just program the digital miner and go get some tin, right? We need to fill up one more bucket of water and go... Actually, I could just... Let's do it here in the blue one, just because it's closer. There you go. And we can go fill up one... Actually, I could have made an infinite water pool with that bucket of water without having to go take a walk of shame all the way over to the river and doing a little bit of that. There you go. All right, let's go back and fill in that cultivator with some water, and we should be good to go. And we can make that coelacanth, throw it inside the thing. Of course, we have to fill it up with water first. Oof. Don't want to just throw it inside of there right now. We can put wheat inside here. Yeah, we have a lot of wheat. I don't remember where we got. Oh, yeah, I was using that to multiply all the sheep. Anyways, let's grab ourselves a coelacanth. 100%. There you go. And let's let that thing cultivate inside of there. There you go. And in the meantime, I probably should have filled up all these water buckets. glowstone. Do we have any glowstone? Glowstone, yeah, of course we do. Oof, 14 glowstone blocks. Where should we put the blocks, actually? Maybe like one or two of them. I don't know. I'm thinking, yeah, one of them here, obviously. Or put them... let's put it there at the top. And then we'll need another one about right here. Yeah. About right there. Yeah, that should be good. And then, of course, fill this up with some blue glass. And let's get some sandstone. And we're going to wall this off, like so. And I guess, how am I going to get out of here? I don't know. Maybe we'll just dig through the top. Who knows? Anyways, put down all the water like so. It's going to be a little different because this is a closed off area, not just a completely open top area like all the coelacanth expansions that we've been working on lately. All right, guys, this place is completely filled up with water. Real quick, though, maybe while I'm inside here, we could put another glowstone. I don't know, 1, 2, 3, where is it, is there a center to this? I don't know if there is. Maybe we put it like, I don't know, here, maybe, yeah? Yeah, we can put it like right here, yeah, about right there. Put it right there, put the glowstone there, and make this place nice and lit up. Now I need to break this glass, just so we can escape out of here. Hopefully none of the stuff actually breaks inside here like they did last time, because I know that some of his carpet went flying all over the place, so we have to replace his carpet here in a minute. It's a straight up water leak inside here, man. Oh, I need to place down the glass there, actually, not the sandstone. And glass. Whew. Oh, man. There you go. Oh, man, I have to break it again to put the ceiling can inside there. Whoops. Oh, man. Okay, well, let's place down all of his carpets again. That ones that broke. Not too much of his apartment was carpet anyways, so should be easy. Yeah, there you go. And surely by now, the coelacanth will be done, right? Yeah. There you go. And we can just go lay it inside of there by, I don't know, going around here. just trying to get out of the way of that, all that water over there, just so it doesn't spill on top of us. And there we go. Okay, whew, we can just lay down the egg, like, right there. And hopefully it'll... actually hatch? and it'll live inside of there. It'll be really good. And maybe later we can put some like coral reefs and stuff inside of there, make it look really, really good. Put the sandstone back and I think we're good to go. Yeah, there's the coelacanth egg. All right, well, I guess we're just going to sit here for a little while, wait for the coelacanth to hatch, and I'll see you guys here in a bit. Oh, man. Oh, there we go. It's hatched. It's hatched and tamed. Fantastic. Oh, man. And it's swimming over here. Or it looked like it was. All right, look at that. We have a little coelacanth inside of there. Now, of course, we could put maybe 3-4 of them inside of there. But as I said at the beginning, you know, he's going to grow up. He's going to get pretty big. He's going to be like pretty much the size of this whole entire area by the time he's an adult. So don't want to put too many of them inside of there or else it'll look ridiculous. Anyways, it already looks fantastic just the way it is. And yeah, we're stuck here. Dominus, that he needs to get over here and just look at his amazing. Hey, get inside of here, Dr. Dominus. What are you doing? Go inside there. Go look at your brand new, fantastic new aquarium. It's absolutely insane. Oh, why are you shaking your head? No, why do you not want to see your coelacanth? Is it because she's tame to me, technically? Oh, yeah, I saw you nod your head right there. Well, I don't know what to say about that. You should have been next to him whenever he hatched, but you can just go inside there and just take a little gander at him. Just take a little peekaroo and hopefully he'll like you. You can feed him a little bit of, I don't know, fish? No, coelacanth don't. God, he's sour. Oh, man, he's so sour. He's so sour, man. Oh, man. Anyways, you're going to go back in your apartment eventually. You're going to have to see that coelacanth and you're going to love it, huh? You're going to love it, Dr. Anonymous. Anyways, we need to go continue working on our little penthouse over there. So what do we want? I guess real quick, do we have like extra crafting tables we can grab real quick? Maybe we do inside of the thing. Crafting stations. Yeah, we have literally like 4 of them inside here. Jeez. We can just place them down over there and of course keep accessing our network, our ME network from our wireless terminal, which is absolutely fantastic. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Is that gonna, oh yeah, forgot we had to call down the elevator first, and then it'll come down to the first floor and it'll be ready for passengers such as myself. And oh, there you go. Man, I'm really liking everything. I'm really liking how everything's turning out. Of course I need to put, god, do I, oh wow, this is a great opportunity. A green green stained glass panes, but is that lime? Yeah, there you go, get some lime and we'll be good to go. Just put that here. Yeah, see that wireless ME terminal? Fantastic. There you go. Now I finally filled in that glass. After all these, I wouldn't say years, but maybe Minecraft years, I don't know. Anyways, let's go inside the elevator and let's go to 122, the penthouse, our penthouse. And what should we put up there? I don't know if we want to completely design the whole entire penthouse right now. Maybe just get general out. Like outlines, you know, kind of like what we did for Dr. Indominus's thing, where I just like said, oh, this is the kitchen, this is where the living room is going to be, this is where the blah blah is going to be. Maybe I'll do that. And yeah, I guess we just throw down a crafting station real quick. Do we have any, what was it, clear glass? Yeah, we have a little bit of clear glass. I think we can make some clear glass panes. Let's just fill in some of these windows, right? Just fill these in, make them look fantastic. We already put the acacia there last at the end of last episode, so we don't have to worry about those. Now we have to worry about the random, I don't even know what they call that, like pain in the middle of the pain. I don't even know what that is. It looks awful. It looks just terrible. Oh man. Let's grab some more of the clear glass. There we go. Should be able to make like 2 crafts of it, right? Yeah, there we go. Whew, 32 clear glass. And I guess I could just fill the rest of that on my own. Don't really need to do that on camera. Get all the buckets and throw those inside of the ME network. There you go. Almost just threw the ME terminal, wireless terminal inside of the ME network. That would have been absolutely awful. We can put the limestone clay back there, or limestone glass, and the regular clear glass. Now, what do we want over here? I guess we can use acacia. Yeah, we can use acacia because everything else uses acacia, and of course, jungle. We want to use a lot of jungle. Let's just grab all that. Whew. And, I guess for right now, we could just outline the general, like, look of how this place is going to look, you know? Of course, I did say I want to have, like, a little balcony, like, right here, kind of look, overlooking this whole main area right here, so, and one of these areas here is going to be the staircase area, and which side isn't going to be the staircase area? I'm thinking about turning that into the kitchen, you know? Yeah. I'm liking that shape. Yeah, you know, because we'll have a kitchen here, staircase here, living room here. You know, I'm just throwing ideas out here. And I don't know, actually, maybe dining area here, living room here, bedroom upstairs. It'd kind of be like an open loft, you know? It wouldn't really have rooms. It'd just be like a big studio loft in the penthouse. That'd be really cool. Yeah, that'd be really cool and unique. Man, okay, let's grab, whew, I'm getting ideas absolutely out of the butt right now. Actually, if we're going to have a kitchen here, how far is this going? About out to here? Kind of want to either do that, if we're going to have the kitchen here, or maybe we could put a bar here? Oh, a bar, kind of like what I did for Dr. Indominus's house? Oh, that's going to look fantastic. All right, okay, let me just put a placeholder here for the bar. Okay, so this side is going to be the kitchen side. Confirmed. Hashtag confirmed kitchen. And we can put the staircase here, and it'll be like this shape, you know? Yeah. That'd be perfect. Okay, so it won't be like a 2x2. It'll be a 3x3, and it'll go up. Yeah, that'll be good. Let's see if maybe carpenter's blocks, and we can use acacia for it. That way, you know, have good contrast with the jungle wood planks and stuff, you know? We do have a lot of acacia. We just grabbed an absolute ton of it. Carpenters. Yeah, we have a lot of carpenter stairs. Fantastic. Let's grab the hammer just in case we need it. And let's just start building the staircase, I guess. And we can put the staircase like so. We can put this like that. There we go. And the corner blocks are going to have to be flat, you know? So we can just use regular acacia there. There we go. We just use regular old acacia there. I don't know, like this, like that. Yeah, that's good. And we just fill this one in like so, fill this one in like so. And yeah, I'm liking it. I actually, if we're going to fill that in, it might as well face the same way as the staircase itself. Yeah, there you go. And we're going to need a block there, and this is going to have to be flat. And yeah. Yeah, it's not going to be too bad. And of course, stair and flat. It's going to have to be like this. There we go. Get rid of these. And block. Actually, whoops. Block. And these are going to have to be like this. Yeah, there we go. Actually, it's going to have to be more like this. There we go. All right, this is... let's just get rid of the extra acacia, hashtag extra acacia. Man, I'm throwing too many hashtags out there. Ooh, they're going to start losing their value soon. Yeah. See how this looks already. And maybe we put like fence supports here, you know, make it look really, really good. Maybe just on the corners too. This isn't turning out too bad. Yeah, of course it could look better. And this will take us to the second floor. So it needs to go up one more right here. So we're going to put the stair block like so, and this will take us to the second floor, or the penthouse, or the loft, or whatever you want to call it. There we go. Oh, whoa, just fell and just placed a block perfectly on my little fall. So, and then of course it'll keep going up. So right here will be another stair like that. And then right here is going to be the corner. Oh, whoops, gotta keep falling right there. And I'm gonna need to hammer this. Like, whoops. Oh man, this is awful. This is turning out terrible. There we go. And fill it in like so. There we go. Oh god, not like that. There we go. Fill it in like... Come on. Is it possible for me to... Oh, there we go. Alright, perfect. I don't know how I'm liking these acacia stairs, though. They look weird. Maybe they'd look better with the acacia supports. Maybe, I don't know. Either way, we need to get rid of these and put, you know, jungle there just so it matches the floor. Actually, we can get the jungle right now. We have jungle there. Get rid of the torches. We don't really need torches right now. And this is what the second floor, the loft or whatever it is going to be. So we just fill that in, see what it looks like when it's completely filled in. Like so. There we go. And we could just build this out to about the mid area, you know? Oh, well, I'm gonna need more jungle. There we go. 1¾ stacks. All right, so let's just fill all this in. And this is going to be the balcony. And it's going to look pretty good. There you go. And of course the staircase is going to be, you know, it's going to keep going up one more layer. So I don't know which way is this going to face once it gets out. I don't know. I'm going to have to figure that out here in a bit. And then we're going to need another stair there. Do that, do that, do that. Another stair there. Do that, do that, do that. Another stair there. And do that. Oh, up that, that, and that. Another stair there. And we just hippity hop can't stop right here. Place that, place that, place that. And what is this? Is this going to be the roof? I think it is. Yeah, yeah. I think it's going to be the roof layer. So, yeah, yeah, yeah. So, if we're going to be... I don't know. I'm thinking here, like... Because, of course, we're going to have a pool. Ah, that's right. So, if we're going to have a pool, it's going to go inside the ceiling of my penthouse, and that won't be good. So, maybe this will go up, like, maybe three more blocks or something, you know? Let's actually see how that looks. One, two, three. Yeah, that's how it'd look. Then, of course, this would be the ceiling of my actual penthouse. So you wouldn't really notice that it's even there, because it'd literally be above us. And we'd have a ceiling here, and you wouldn't see it unless you took the staircase, of course. And fill all this in like so. And that'll be three blocks taller. And then this would be the actual floor, which would give us room to have a three block deep pool without it constructing or obstructing our ceiling over there. That'd be really cool. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay. All right, so this is going to be a huge building project, I'll tell you that much. Whew, I'm going to have to, I don't know. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Maybe this bit here could be our attic for storage. Or, yeah, I don't know why I'm saying that, because we have literally, like, unlimited storage right now. Literally in the palm of our hand with a wireless terminal. So, I don't know what we could use it for. I might just have to light it up a bunch with the torches just to make sure spookies don't spawn up here and start, you know, making a ruckus. Or just fill it all in with dirt or something, you know, just to make sure nothing can spawn up here. But I'm liking how this is turning out so far. This is going to be the dedicated kitchen area. Of course, we need to keep on filling this thing in just so we know what goes where. It's going to be the dedicated kitchen area. We can decorate it, I guess, next episode, because this episode's getting pretty long. And this could be the dining area. We could have a pretty good sized dining table, about like that. Or maybe like, yeah, 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 like that. 4 blocks by 2 blocks. Yeah, 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 that's a pretty big size. And then over here, whew, you bet we're going to have like six Mr. Crayfish TVs, a really big couch, actually. Yeah, we have a couch like right now. We can just throw down a couch like right there. And that's going to be really, really good looking. And I don't know what we could put here. I don't know. If you guys have any ideas for furnishing our penthouse up here, you know, feel free to leave a comment down below. I always read comments, and I always get a ton of really good suggestions by you guys. So, you know, by reading the comments. So feel free to leave comments down below if you have a really, really cool suggestion. Then, hey, it may make it into next episode. So I think what I'm going to do now is leave off, you know, fill in the rest of this, fill in the ceiling, fill in the roof. Ceiling or roof floor, I guess you call it. And yeah, I think I'll just do that between now and next episode. Read you guys' suggestions, and next episode we can start working on furnishing the actual penthouse here and make it look absolutely fantastic. Anyways, thank you guys all very much for watching. If you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to let me know by leaving a like down below. And if you guys want more of these awesome videos, be sure to hit that subscribe button. I'll put my latest videos on YouTube homepage as soon as they come out so you don't miss an episode. But until then, thank you guys all for watching. And I'll see you guys here next time. Oh, bye there. Actually, the kitchen, this is going to be the bar area, you know? We're going to have stools here. Maybe we can have another one. About right here. Maybe the kitchen entrance could be 2 blocks wide and have a mini bar, like, right here. Ooh, that's going to be pretty dankaroonies. Yeah, right next to the dining table, too. Yeah, that's going to be pretty cool. And of course, over here, we're going to have the TVs. So there's that. And, you know, the couch extension is going to have to be like that. The couch game is going to be so strong. And we're going to have the coffee table, like right there. Oh, this is going to be fantastic. I don't know what's going to go here. And I guess that's where you guys' comments are going to come into play.